Good morning, friends. Today we have started with another new session that is also most important thing, that is technical analysis of stock marketing. Yeah, basically technical, there are two types of analysis, fundamental and technical analysis. Fundamental analysis we will see, we will come up with the new videos. Let's start with the technical analysis. What is technical analysis? First, what is analysis? Analysis is doing rigorous research on anything, yeah, that is data or information that we have, that is called analysis. What is stock analysis? The stock data that we have and the history we have regarding to stock markets, and we used to do that data for our analysis, that is called stock analysis. Why we require? What we are expecting in stock marketing? Earning money. How you will earn money? When stock price moves up from your investing point, right? Yes. So in order to predict that movement, you need to do this analysis. Then what is technical analysis? There are two kinds of analysis. One is technical analysis, another one is fundamental analysis of any stock. Okay, what is fundamental analysis? That is company's profile, company standard values, and also financial statements. Researching all those things is called fundamental analysis. Then what is technical analysis? Let's see how it's working. Technical analysis assumes that price movement is prime and price movement is also trend. History will repeat. What this means? Something odd, or you got the point? Okay, let me explain. Price movement is prime. Actually, technical analysis is completely based on its price movement, not any factors. Okay, the indicators, they have designed for only the price actions, how the price is moving, whether it is moving up or down, or it's moving in sidewards. Based on that, our technical analysis has been defined and also designed. And the price movement is also trend, means whether it is in moving up direction or it is in moving down direction. It is not like it will stay at a constant point. That is, price movement is also trend. Is trend means it's in trend. Trend, we know trend is moving, whether it is up or down, it's trend. History will repeat. Once you find some kind of a pattern in the charts, what is charts, we will come later in the same video. Once you find some kind of a patterns in the chart, then they will repeat future. If you identify the starting of the chart pattern, then you can understand that this pattern can be repeated. These are the assumptions that we will take for technical analysis. Not assumptions, these are some kind of statements that we can take as a benchmarks. These things can happen generally. Let's start with trend identification. First thing is finding the trend. Finding the trend means, actually there are three kind of trends in a stock technical analysis, that is uptrend, sideward trend, downtrend. What is uptrend? This is not a some kind of a class lecture that there should be some kind of a definition at all. We will go to the practical things. What is uptrend? What is downtrend? What is sideward trends? Okay, this is not kind of any kind of a certification class, right? So we need to know what is the practicality. How practically uptrend looks? How practically side trend looks? How practically downtrend looks? That's what we want. Okay, let's see. Yeah, this is the stock of ICICI Bank. Okay, if you see from the beginning, yeah, it is moving upward, means price is moving upward. Actually, some kind of a standard definition is there. We need not to go for those things. See them physically, how it is looking. It's looking, it's moving up, price is moving up. So it's an uptrend. Actually, some kind of a standard is there, some lowest of the If you join all the lowest lines, then it forms a straight line. That is called trend line. And so if it is moving downwards, then if you join all the tops of the downtrend, it will form a straight line. That is called downtrend. There's no need to think all those things. We will go with the general form. That will be helpful to us. Don't take more panic or don't do much into this. Okay. Yeah, it's price moving here. It's an upward trend. It's a going downtrend, uptrend, downtrend. Okay. This is downtrend. This is sideward, small sideward. This is uptrend. If you want to see somewhere end of a sideward trend, then I will show you. Good sideward. Yes, see here it is. See here, from here it has been moved to here. Okay, this is upward trend, I can say. See, there are kind of a many theoretical definitions. Okay, I don't want you all into get into those things. I just want you people to get into directly how it will look in practicality. Okay, this is looking like upward. Okay, see here the price is moving here and there. It's not going up or it's not going down. Okay, it's moving here and there only. So this is called sideward trend. Okay, in the similar way, this is downward trend. That's all. This is trend identification. You can simply identify the trends. Based on that, we can follow the trends. Okay. How this can be helpful to us? We can see, if we are going in downward trend, then buying a stock in that trend, it's not good. You are going to lose your money. Yeah, it will recover, but you will lose your time. If you lose time, is what? Money. So we should see the trend. What is in which trend the stock is going on? If it isn't moving upward trend, then we will go for a buy option, or otherwise we will stay calm. That is a basic analysis. Without trend analysis, you cannot go further. Trend analysis is the basic analysis. Once you identify the trend, then only you can proceed. That is also, if it is in upward direction, then only go ahead. Otherwise, stop it. Go for another stock. Huh. What is support and resistance levels? Support level, one price level where price starts moving up. Actually, price, when we are in sideward trending, we will see price will oscillate up and down, up and down, up and down like that. But this up will stay. I mean, stock is moving up and it is getting down. Another it is going up, but it will start decreasing from the previous stop. That is the relation. Okay. Let's take some kind of a channel, and the price is moving in between those channels. Top one is called as a resistance level. So price is not able to move above that price, so we can call it as a resistance level. And the below one is, we call it as a support line, because from where it is supporting to move upward. So how to use them? Use support level as a base price. Based on your previous experience, you can identify if it is coming nearly to support level and check it, whether it is strong or weak, and buy that point and sell it at resistance point. This is a basic analysis. We can go into advanced analysis also. Let's start with the small things. If you want to see the how they will look actually, see here, this top is almost equal. Price is oscillating between this region. So you can say it as a sideward trending, and this price movement nearly to this price, what is that? 255 to 259 region is a resistance region, whereas come to below, this is 215 to 220 is a support level. That's all, that's very simple. Volume of a stock. What is volume of a stock? Number of shares bought or sold. Means nowadays the electronic systems have came, so very frequently, high frequency of a buying a stock or selling a stock becomes very high frequency. So what is volume? It's a sum of both buy and sold. Okay, that is called volume of a stock. Why it is important? It has a some kind of a high correlation with the price movements. Means when it's moving upward trend, price moves, volume moves with the increasing volume. When it is in sidewards, it will also oscillate the volume. And when it is moving down, volume will increase in decreasing manner, means in negative way. Okay, means in sold way. How to use them? If price is moving up and your volume is also increasing, then it's showing a strong relation, so you can buy at that point. In some other cases, if price is moving up but your volume is not showing any kind of a correlation, then we can think it of it is a weak signal, so we need not to go for those signals. Let's see the correlation with the things. Okay, see, up to this point the volume level is very low. Yes, right? Yeah, from here it has started trending, moving up. So please check the volume below line, below one is the volume. So please check the volume there. You can see the increase in volume. That is what is the correlation with the volume. And it's oscillating, it's in sideward. Okay, it's also in sideward. See, from here it is, I think it started downward trending and the volume is increasing. In that case, you have to think in a way that selling is in more volume. Stock is getting sold. That is why it is showing an increasing volume. It doesn't mean that people are buying and price is getting decreased. Okay. Next. Chart. What is chart? We might have started with this. Okay, no issues. Now, chart is a representation of a historical data. What is historical data in a stock market? Yeah, obviously price and volume. So it's a we might have studied in our earlier classes, understand what is charts. Okay, so representation of a price and volume is called as a chart. So this is a general example of a chart. So there are different types of charts: line charts, candlestick charts, and bar charts. A line charts is a how stock market is works. Starts with some price, ends with another price. In between, it can move up and down. Okay, line charts are used by closing price or opening price. They will take only one price, either opening price, close price, and they will form a some kind of a chart. Okay, you can see from here. Okay, I will show you. This is a line chart. Okay, you can see here. Okay, you can see here, yes, this is a line chart. Candlestick charts, let's change it. Yeah, see, this is candlestick chart. So how it is analyzed is actually when it is in white color means it is in moving upwards. Okay, price has started at the lowest point and price has moved up to, okay, let's take this candle as a consideration. Okay, I will try to zoom it out. Yes. Okay, let's take this point. This is, they have started with this point, okay, and price has go down to this point and it has again rise to top of it and it has closed at this point. This is the how to analyze candlestick chart. Okay, now bar charts. The bar charts is also another way of this is bar chart. This is also same. They will start with this point. Okay, they will go down, they will move up and they will close it. That is, if it is in green color, say move, trended up, it's in down, red color, it's trended down. That's it. And this is the same basic chart I have added to make you understand how practically the charts might be. Thank you guys. Please watch next video of a technical analysis part 2, because there you will going to get more information and you can follow with this. If you follow these steps, you can get into more practically and you will understand within 10 to 15 days. So that's most important to you people. And please do like or share your experience by commenting, liking, sharing in your social media. Please do this. And if you have any queries, please contact with us. AllStockBuzz site is there. And you can visit AllStockBuzz video channel is there. So you can contact us in any way. Thank you once again.